Today we are going to see force between two parallel current carrying conductors. So in the diagram you can see we have two current carrying conductors, straight conductors of infinite length. They are marked as PQ is one conductor and RS is the other conductor. There are two conductors. PQ is carrying a current I1 and RS is carrying a current I2, both in same direction. Currents are in same direction. Okay. So, since these are current carrying conductors, surrounding the conductor there will be magnetic field. Both conductors will produce magnetic field surrounding it. Because of the magnetic field, both the conductors will experience a force. And now what happens when these two conductors are in magnetic field? Okay, so this current carrying conductor is in the magnetic field of this current carrying conductor. In the same time, this current carrying conductor is in the magnetic field of this current carrying conductor. So, both can experience force. So if the forces are opposite in direction or forces are in same in direction, then there can be either attraction or repulsion. We will see what happens in the situation. Okay. Now let us see. This is a current carrying conductor RS. Let us choose a point on the conductor RS. Let us choose this point. This is the point. Okay. So current is in this direction for this conductor PQ. Now by right hand thumb rule, if we place like this, At this point, what is the direction of magnetic field? Current is carrying like this. If this is a conductor, current is carried like this. So at this point, magnetic field is inward. Considering the board, magnetic field is inward. I can say magnetic field is into the board. I will give a symbol into. Magnetic field is inward at this point. Okay. So for this current carrying conductor, magnetic field is inward. What is the strength of the magnetic field of this current carrying conductor at this point? This is at a distance R. So I can say the magnetic field of this current carrying conductor, I will say BPQ. BPQ is equal to, we have learned the equation mu 0 I 1 by 2 pi r. This is the equation for magnetic field of this current carrying conductor at this point. Okay. Now this current carrying conductor is in the magnetic field of having this value. So this should experience a force. What is the force experience? Force experienced by RS. F RS is equal to F is equal to B I L sin theta. So B is BPQ. BPQ. Then I will take I2. Okay. Then L. I am just using force per length. I can say force per length. Force per length. So length need not consider. B I L I haven't considered because it is force per length. Force on RS per length is equal to into sin theta. What is the angle between the magnetic field and the current? They are 90 degrees. So sin theta is sin 90 is 1. I can use sin 90. Okay. So what is the resulting equation? Force per length. Force on the conductor RS per length is equal to BPQ into I2. Okay. So what is I2? What is BPQ? BPQ having a value mu 0 I1 by 2 pi R into the current I2. This is the force. I'll give equation number 1. So this is the force experienced by the current carrying conductor or RS. Okay, per length. This is the equation of force. F RS per length. And what's the direction of the force? We need to see the direction of the force. To understand direction of the force, we need to use the Fleming's left hand rule. So we know that magnetic field is inward at the point. This is magnetic field, forefinger. Forefinger is inward. And this is current. Current this finger. Current is inward. Current is upward. Current upward, magnetic field inward. What about the thumb? Thumb is towards left side. Okay. So we can see this direction is towards left side. This is the direction of the force. Force is FRS. Okay. Now in the same manner, we will find the force on this current carrying conductor. And for that, we will choose a point somewhere here. This current carrying conductor will produce a magnetic field at this point. What's the direction of magnetic field? This is the current. So I place a thumb like this. Thumb current in this direction. I need to grasp to this point. When I grasp to this point, I can see current is outward. Here if magnetic field was inward, here magnetic field is outward. So this is a current carrying conductor. At this point, magnetic field is outward. I will show this by a symbol dot. This is outward. So at this point, I can say magnetic field is outward direction. Okay. What is the strength of the magnetic field? of this current carrying conductor at this point, we can say strength of the magnetic field is B. This conductor is producing magnetic field BRS is equal to mu 0 I2 by 2 pi R, same distance R. Okay. Now this current carrying conductor is in this magnetic field and it will experience a force. What will be the equation for force? F acting on this PQ. Force acting on PQ per length. We can get the equation. Force is equal to magnetic field. That is magnetic field is BRS. Magnetic field of this current carrying conductor BRS into. Then current carried by this conductor is I1 into sin A. Okay, it is equal to what is BRS? BRS equal to mu 0 I2 by 2 pi R into I1. Or it is equal to mu 0 I1 I2 by 2 pi R. It is equation number 2. Now we can see that both forces per length are equal in magnitude. What about direction of the force on this conductor? To understand direction of force on the conductor, again we have to use Fleming's left hand rule. So at this point, magnetic field is outward. So magnetic field is outward. Then current is upward. How can you show this? Magnetic field is outward. Current is upward. See, current is upward. Forefinger magnetic field is in this direction. What is the direction of force? Force is along towards the right side. This is the direction of force. Current upward. Magnetic field outward. Okay. The force is towards right side. Now I'll mark the force. Now we can see the force on PQ. I will say FPQ per length is in this direction. Now we can see these two forces are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. What happens is these two conductors will experience a mutual force. So the conductors will come closer. Okay. If currents are in same direction, the conductors will experience an attractive force. And we can show that if one of the current is reversed, if this is I1, if this current is reversed in direction, same conductor PQ and RS, same situation, distance is R, then we can show that the force on this conductor is having this direction, that is FRS, and what about FPQ? FPQ will be in opposite direction. They are repelling each other. So this conductor will have tendency to move this direction, this to move this direction. So they will repel. We can show these two directions with the help of right-handed thumb rule. Magnitudes will be remaining the same, but directions will be opposite. Okay, so in the same manner, we can see the forces will be opposite in direction, not approaching, the conductors are repelling. Okay, so this is the force between two parallel current carrying conductors. Okay, thank you.